Hey everyone, welcome to the T.A.R channel. For those of you who've been here before, welcome back. I know it's been a while since we posted anything, but in today's video, we're going to show you how to install LDPlayer. So in the past couple of weeks, our group has been asked numerous times on how to install LDPlayer and what settings should they use for the Disney Zoom Zoom game. The reason I'm going to assume why this is happening is because since Disney no longer supports the 32-bit version of the game, those people who were currently running the Nox emulator no longer works, and now they're going to have to switch over to LDPlayer or an Android device. Well, in today's video, we're going to show you how to set this up and what settings we recommend. And of course, if you have any questions, you're welcome to visit us via the QR code in the background or from the link in the video description below. Alright, so let's get started. What you're going to do is open up a browser, head over to this webpage called ldplayer.net. You're going to choose previous versions, and you're going to install LDPlayer 5 64-bit. Unfortunately, LDPlayer 9 doesn't work yet with Disney Zoom Zoom, so your only option is LDPlayer 5 64-bit. Click on that, download it, install it. Once you get that installed, it'll take anywhere from 2 to 5 minutes, depending on how fast your PC is. It's going to auto open up, and it's going to look a lot bigger than what you see on my screen because the default resolution is a lot larger. And I'm going to show you what the recommended screen resolution is once this thing is up and loaded. So once it comes up and everything's loaded, you're going to click on the three horizontal lines on the top right hand corner. You're going to click settings, and right here the first thing you're going to do is select mobile mode and select 540 by 960. Leave the rest as default. Model, you can choose whatever preset phone you want. I normally just go with the Samsung Galaxy S10, S10 Plus, whatever is fine. You're going to leave everything here default. And then on the last tab, the other settings, you're going to enable fixed window size, which is what I recommend. And then you're going to change the root permission to enable. Once you enable that, you click Save Settings. It's going to ask you to restart. You go ahead and restart LDPlayer. And then once it restarts, it's going to look like this. Once this is loaded, what you're going to want to do is click on the System Apps. Go to Settings. Scroll all the way down to About Tablet. You're going to click on that. Scroll all the way down, click on the build number 7 times, and what's going to do is enable developer mode. I'm already a developer, so that's why you're going to see this. But once you go ahead and click on that 7 times, you'll be a developer. Click the back button, and then you'll have developer options enabled for you there. Click on developer options, scroll down to USB debugging, enable this, and the rest you can leave as default. And back out. All right, back onto the main screen. Click on System Apps, go to the Play Store, and what you're going to want to do is search for the RobotMon app. You're going to want to install this. I already have it installed, but go ahead and install this. Once you're done with the RobotMon app, you're going to install the RobotMon root app. And what this is going to do is it's going to start the service for you without having to use the Service Manager third-party application. So go ahead, install RobotMon Launcher Root. Once that's done, you can search for the Disney game. Go ahead and install this. Once you get everything installed, go ahead and open up RobotMon first. You're going to get prompted with a couple of settings or prompts that appear in the front. Just go ahead and click through all of that. Once you get through that, you're going to click on the script store. You're going to scroll down to the Disney Zoom Zoom script, and the latest version currently is 73. You're going to click on this folder. It's going to ask you want to download. You say yes, it downloads. Here you go. And you're going to click on the folder again to launch the script. And it should pop up on the top left-hand corner. You may get a pop-up that says, do you want to allow this to display over other apps? You're going to click yes, And what it's going to do is it may bring you to the settings page, and you're going to have to enable robot mod to display over other applications. And then once you get that enabled, you come back here and it should just look like this. Go ahead and click on the settings icon on top here. This is the script settings for the robot mod, and I'm not going to go into too much detail here, but this is where you can choose if you want to auto buy boxes when the premium boxes or the capsule or the select boxes appear during events. You can go ahead and click on this to enable how many boxes you want to auto buy. Okay, and if you want to auto play the game, go ahead and choose this. You can go ahead and choose all your boosters that you want to use during autoplay. This is where you choose your zoom that you want to use. Unfortunately, not every zoom is listed here. There's specific zooms that you can choose, and the ones that aren't listed will either be a burst or a pair zoom. All right, and then once you get that selected, you can either receive all your hearts together, which is not the recommended for people who are in zoom groups. The recommended settings are receive hearts one by one, skip first person if you have ads, especially in LD player. I think there's ads in LD player, so you're going to have to choose skip first person so you don't click on the ad when it's doing the auto. The rest here is how many minutes you want to how many times you want to open the mailbox before it auto plays or starts sending down leaderboard, this and that. But I'm not going to go into too much of this detail. If you have questions regarding this, you can go ahead and visit us online and we can help you out, or you can, you know, scrounge through Google, Reddit. I'm sure there'll be people who explain what each settings are for you. All right. Once you get that done, you're going to open up Robot Mod Launcher. You're going to start the service. When you get, you may get a prompt on here before you able to start it. Just go ahead and hit, I believe it is, select the choice forever or something like that comes up. It says, do you want to allow? And just say, make sure you choose forever, not 10 minutes or not once. All right, click forever, hit yes, then go ahead and start the service here. And if you want to see if it's working, go back into RobotMon, the script, and you'll see the service is on here. That means that the script is going to work once you launch it. And then from here on out, just open up the game, log into your profile. To start the RobotMon script, just click the play button. Once you get all your settings that you want done, go ahead and click play. And if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us online via the QR code in the background or from the link in the video description below. As always, thank you for visiting the site and happy Zoom Zoom. Bye.